Hello once again, my friends. Welcome back. It is the Morning Mindset. Kerry Green here. Hope you're ready to join me in getting your mind aligned with the truth of God's Word. That's what I'm doing today. And we're going to be doing so by looking at Genesis 14, 21 through 24. Now, friends, to get us into the subject, let me ask you, have you ever been overlooked for a promotion? Or has someone else ever gotten the credit for something you did? Let's keep that context and the feelings that that generates, as you remember it, in mind as we read today. This is Genesis 14, 21 through 24. It says, "And the king of Sodom said to Abram, 'Give me the persons, but take the goods for yourself.' But Abram said to the king of Sodom, 'I have lifted my hand to the Lord, God Most High, possessor of heaven and earth, that I would not take a thread or a sandal strap or anything that is yours, lest you should say, "I've made Abraham rich." And I will take nothing but what the young men have eaten and the share of the men who went with me. Let Aner and Eshcol and Mamre take their share." Now, the situation here is one where Abram went and he rescued a bunch of people from some conquering kings. And some of those people were the king of Sodom's people, actually the inhabitants of his city, Sodom. And he's wanting to reward Abram. But Abram is saying, "I've taken a vow before the Lord that I won't take anything from you so that you can't get credit for making me rich." Isn't that an interesting motive? Even though the guy seems to have a good motive, he wants to give Abram thanks by giving him his choice of all the things that he's taken. Abram refuses to take anything. And his reason is he wants to make sure God gets the credit. And apparently that's a vow he made to God, an agreement between him and God. Friends, I think what we need to focus in on here is that at this point in Abram's story, God is beginning to become the focal point of his life. You see, it's not just that he's worshiping him, creating idols and all that sort of stuff. He is learning to trust God and to put all of his chips on that number, so to speak. You see, I think the lesson we need to learn here, friends, is that God or his son Jesus are not accessories that we can add to our life. They are the center point of our life. If you think of something like a bicycle wheel and how it has the different spokes, many times we make God a spoke in our life. He's one part of our life. And then we have another spoke that's our hobbies, and we have another spoke that's our family, and we have another spoke that's this or that or work, you know. But God really, friends, is the hub of that wheel. He's the axle. He's the thing that everything revolves around. And that's what Abram's learning here, that God's his focal point, his purpose, his reason. And so, friends, I want to ask you, what role does Jesus play in your life? Is he like that axle, that hub to the wheel, where he is central to everything and everything revolves around him, like it was the case for Abram? Or is he someone you talk up when you're among other believers, but you're unwilling to say anything about him when you're around people who don't believe in him? Is he someone that you give lip service to, but you're unwilling to submit your attitudes and your behavior and your beliefs to him? Friends, I heard it said one time that Jesus is either Lord of all or he's not Lord at all. Now, that's not at all questioning Jesus' lordship in terms of the facts of it. What it's saying is it's pointing to our attitude. And we either consider him to be Lord of everything in our lives, or we have not really submitted ourselves to him at all. Because Jesus doesn't give us the option of having a little bit of this and a little bit of that when it comes to his instruction and his demands for our life. Jesus says it's an all or nothing thing. I am the way, I am the truth, I am the life, and no one will come to the Father except by me. That's direct quotation from Jesus. Jesus also says, unless you hate your father, your mother, your sister, your brothers, even your own life, you cannot be my disciple. You see, Jesus' teaching is a hard teaching because it makes him exclusive. It makes him the very center of our very existence. But friends, let me say this. I made the decision many years ago by the power of his Holy Spirit leading me to make him the Lord of my life And it's a decision I've never regretted because he is a good Lord. He is a gracious Lord. He is a powerful Lord. And he does amazing things in the lives of those who will trust him. Lord Jesus, I pray for my friends right now who are listening. I know there are many who have given their lives fully to you, and they trust you to be Lord of their lives. But I also know there are many who do not, Lord, for all of us. Give us that willingness to give more of ourselves to you, to give all of ourselves to you, and to make you Lord over all in our lives, so that our lives revolve around you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.